Hey guys, it's Chris. Today I'm going to talk to you about why I bought a GH4 in 2019 and how that's worked out for me so far. Stick around, it's going to be great. Today we're talking about a recent camera purchase I made, the Panasonic GH4. Now, why would I buy something outdated in 2019, 2020? I picked this up in September and November, and I got it for $400. So what are the features of the GH4 that are nice? Well, you have uncompressed output here to the HDMI port, which you can put Vlog on. Recording Vlog, you can slap the LUT on, super easy, super cinematic looking shots. Also, shoots anamorphic. Does it de-squeeze the image in the little itty bitty tiny screen? No, but if you're shooting with anamorphic lenses, you probably want a slightly larger monitor in your little setup. It's pretty easy to get a small little setup with a monitor, so you can properly display it. But it shoots anamorphic, and it shoots slow motion at 96 frames a second, which for me is actually slow enough. I like 120, but 96 is good enough. The sensor inside of here is a 4/3 sensor, but when I had my JVC, I was just recording 95% of the time with 4/3 anyway, so wasn't really a huge difference switching between the two cameras. And then the other thing about it is it shoots 4K at 30p, shoots 1080 at 96 frames a second. It shoots in good quality. It shoots super high bit rate. It shoots .mov files. It's really nice, really easy camera to work with. I just picked it up. I had the Panasonic 2500. For a while, then I switched it out for this, and it's really, really nice. I can shoot all the slow motion I want to, but I have with the speed booster and even some of the fast zooms from Panasonic, really good quality indoor shooting slow motion. Also, it's very easy to adapt broadcast lenses to this camera, which is very nice for some of the shooting I do. So all in all, this is a really, really, really good option for what I do, which is slow motion B-roll, interview shots, time lapses, things like that. And the battery life's phenomenal. The quality is phenomenal. It's $400. Let's talk about downsides of the GH4 compared to the GH5, GH5S. This fundamentally, with image stabilization, it's about the same as the GH5S. You're not going to get too much more. Obviously, if you use a newer lens on the newer body, you're going to get something a little bit better. You also get a slightly wider field of view. Otherwise, outside of higher bit rates and full HDMI port and some better uncompressed options through that port, it's not a huge difference. You're really just getting down to some nitty-gritties and you don't have 60p and 4K. But I either shoot slow motion or I shoot everything for 30p. Very rarely do I shoot 60 frames a second. I either shoot slow-mo and then speed it up to regular speed, or I shoot slow motion. Like I don't need to shoot 60 frames a second in the work that I do in 4K. 1080 of all the options, so you know, that's a downside. Do I need that flexibility? No. If you need that flexibility, I recommend the GH5s. Things are good, I don't believe. lens options I've made are for the 4/3 sensor size and Super 35. That's the frame I like. That's the sensor size I like. I don't need more than a 4/3 or a 35 millimeter sensor. I just don't. The GH5S has amazing low light capabilities, and I don't see myself ever leaving this size of sensor, at least not for a very long time. It took me forever just to get out of 2/3 inch and 1 inch sensors. It took me years just to get out of those sensor sizes to this. So I think full frame is a little, it's too much. It's too much for at least the kind of work I do. The depth of field, it's just too much. And also you run into issues with lens length. Then you can't get far enough. And in my work, getting wide enough isn't hard. I slap a 12 on here, I'm wide. It's wide angle, it's just like a broadcast lens under a hoop. It's good enough. I don't need anything wider than that. So the issue for full frame for me would be reach. I can't zoom in on the 140 to 14 to 140 lens on here. I can zoom in the 140, well that's like 300 millimeters. And I can even do the extended telecrop and get even further. So I don't really need a full frame sensor or the GH5S sensor. So the sensor size has not been an issue for me. The low light, the depth of field, everything, it's perfect for the work that I do. But I recommend the GH4 in 2020? I sure would. If you can't afford a GH5, or you don't need all the features of a GH5, this is a damn good camera. I really appreciate all you guys giving me all the attention you have with comments, questions, and suggestions on all of my social media platforms, including YouTube. It's part of the reason why I decided to make a video tonight. And now that I have the time to, I'm gonna thoroughly enjoy that quite a bit. I do like making these videos, that's for sure. Thanks so much for watching, commenting, and subscribing. I'm excited to make some more videos for you guys. I hope you're all staying healthy and staying quarantined like me. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you later. Maybe I should grab the camera. we'll put you on it. Maybe we should grab the camera we're talking about. So, all right, we did it. We did it, everybody. We made the video. We did it. We fucking did it, people. So yeah, the zombies are gonna be here any minute. Ha 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 ha.